Hello everyone, this is Ritika Joshi, an alumna of Amrapali Group of Institutes, currently working as an assistant system engineer at TCS. Be it Sandeep Bhaiya or Abhilash, the whole nation went gaga over this amalgamation of a wonderful storyline, amazing direction and a powerful acting aspirants. Today, I feel delighted to have with me on our channel, Mr. Apoor Singh Karke, who is the brilliant mind behind this amazing masterpiece. He is the creative head at Timeliners and the creative director at TVF. And it is such an honor to have
Thank you
on our channel.
Thank you so much.
So coming up from as a student from St. Joseph's to being the assistant director, then being a director, then reaching the heights of success today, how would you sum up your whole journey?
I think किसी भी industry में, for any industry, if you look at it that way, I think it takes a lot of years to reach a certain place. I think what is important is to focus on the journey and not really. I don't consider it as, I don't look at it in a way that I have reached a mark, because for me, what's coming next is also part of the journey. But yes, of course, it feels great because there is an overwhelming amount of love that we've received for aspirants. And I also feel that somewhere aspirants was a show that completed a circle for me, because I have myself been a UPSC aspirant. It feels great from being a kid from Nainital to reach an industry which we all aspire to be a part of. I think it's been a tremendous journey. And a lot of them, my parents, my brother, my wife, a lot of them has supported me a lot all through these years. And I think wherever I am today, I think a lot of it, in fact, the most of it is God's role. So yeah, it feels great.
Your journey is truly inspiring, sir. So filmmaking and direction actually looks a lot easy up front, but it actually involves a lot of patience, dedication, hard work. So what were your challenges during the initial phase of your career and what were your learnings?
That's a good question, but what happens is it's a craft. So for any craft, you have to learn first. So I think initial 5 to 6 years are spent learning the craft. You become an assistant director or you become an assistant editor. Or an intern assistant director, intern art director. The initial 6 to 7 years are spent mostly in learning the craft, because there is so much to filmmaking. It's an ocean. If you look at a particular scene, any scene, if you take example of aspirants, Sandeep Bhaiya and Abhilash scene where they were sitting inside a room and having a great conversation. If you just look at that scene, I think there are at least 200 people involved in that particular scene, because right from creating an art setup to costumes to sound design to foley artist to music director to editor to my team assistant directors to me, a lot of people are involved. So I think too, it is such an intricate job that most of it gets you learn for most of those years, and then gradually what happens is in the process of 6 to 7 years you decide to take up a lead role. For example, you decide that हाँ मैं एक छोटा show direct करना चाहूँगा, और then gradually you do 6 to 7 small shows for another 5 to 6 years, and then a big show comes into your kitty which will probably change the course of your career for your life. So that is the process, and I think it remains the same for any industry, be it IT, be it any industry for that matter. What is more important, I feel, is to be consistent at what you do, not giving up, constantly learning. For 10 years, I don't remember who said this statement, but I truly believe that it has motivated me to the very core all through these years. That I think it was Bruce Lee that he said that I am not afraid of a person who has learned 1000 trips 10,000 times, but I am more afraid of a person who has practiced that one trick 1000 times. So I think it is very important to be very consistent at what you do. And I think 10 years you give it to those, you give it to that particular industry, it will reap immense benefit for you.
So that is really moving. And so now it's time for the most awaited question. What inspired you towards creating Aspirants and bring it into the screen?
I think it was, firstly, it wasn't my idea. It was Dipesh who wrote the script. It was his idea, because he was planning, jab hum Flames ki shooting kar rahe the, he told me that mere paas ek hai idea. फ्लेम्स में जो कौशल सर बने हैं, आई डोंट नो इफ यू सीन फ्लेम्स और नॉट, कौशल सर जो बने हैं उन्होंने लिखी है एस्पिरेंट्स. सो आई थिंक व्हेन वी वर शूटिंग फ्लेम्स ही टोल्ड मी दैट ही हैज एन आइडिया. सो आई टेल या लेट्स डेवलप इट, यार करते हैं इसको. सो इट टुक अस ऑलमोस्ट 2.5 years टू राइट दैट स्क्रिप्ट एंड देन 1 year फॉर पोस्ट एंड शूटिंग एंड पोस्ट. सो इट्स अ प्रोसेस ऑफ 3-3.5 years. ऑब्वियसली व्हेन ही इट वॉज सो वेल रिसर्च्ड, इवन व्हेन आई वॉज चूजन एज अ डायरेक्टर फॉर द स्क्रिप्ट, आई थिंक Dipesh is a brilliant writer in the sense that he took a 6 months break and then he went to Rajendra Nagar to research, take interviews, meet hundreds of people, and then collaborating all of that and sinking in those research into script papers is a tremendous job that he's done. So I think for me also, when I came in, it was important for me to convert that beautiful script onto screen. And obviously, I was a UPSC aspirant back in 2015. So all the details that I could fill in into the script were filled in, and then obviously I was directing for a lot of years, so direction plus a UPSC combined combination helped us a lot. So that is how it happened.
So kirana store wale bhaiya ho ya fir tailor bhaiya, people find your character so relatable and is pe based itna sara meme material hai. Jitni achhi aapki direction hai utni achhi aapki acting bhi hai. So personally, which do you love the most, acting or direction?
I think I am more passionate about directing. Acting to main hobby, because hum log ka channel hi hai time lena. So jab bahut zyada hum acting actors bahar se nahi lena chahte to main khud hi kar leta hu. But personally, direction is my passion. I have lived direction for so many years. Acting is something that I do as a choice, as a hobby. So that's the difference, I think.
Sir, as the trend is emerging, people are shifting from the movie theaters to OTT platforms, and as such, there is a constant changing demand by the digital audience. So how do you manage to keep up with it?
I think those are two different worlds. I even in current times, I think in the next 1 year, I don't see theaters going away, because that feel of watching a film in a theater is a completely different world altogether. Yes, OTT has changed the digital world. Everybody can watch it at home. Even the biggest of film stars, you can watch it by paying 200 rupees. So that it has changed the digital platform a lot, but I don't think so theater is going anywhere. Yes, the competition in the sense has increased, because post lockdown what has happened is that a lot of people have shifted to watching, viewing content in OTT platforms. So what has happened is, because of that, obviously the demand has increased. So when the demand has increased, so all the suppliers like TVF, like all the major production houses in Bombay, they have to constantly churn in content to meet that demand. So yes, the competition has increased. Also, with the kind of intelligence the audience are getting now, it is really important for us to constantly prick ourselves to not create bad content. It is really important. And with every second show, is a masterpiece now. If you look at Aspirants ke turant baad Family Man aa gaya. It's a beautiful show. And if you look at Sherni now, it's another beautiful film. So it's good that the competition is there, because whenever there is competition, the output of products is going to be beautiful. So pehle ye nahi hota tha. Theaters mein kuch chosen set of actors and directors hote the, jo unka ek chosen set of trends hota tha, wahi banate the commercial cinema. अब क्या है कि अब ऐसा नहीं है. अब लोग अच्छा कंटेंट बनाना चाहते हैं, एंड इफ इट इज वेल मेड, इट इज गोइंग टू रीच ऑडियंसेस, बी इट ओटीटी, बी इट थिएटर्स. सो दैट्स.
सो कमिंग टू द एंड ऑफ द इंटरव्यू, वुड यू लाइक टू गिव एनी मोटिवेशनल मैसेज टू आवर ऑडियंस?
आई थिंक मोटिवेशन, पता नहीं हाउ मोटिवेटिंग आई एम, बट आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू से दैट इट इज रियली इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एवरीबडी ऑफ अस. मैं इधर वही एक्सपीरियंस वाली बात रिपीट करूंगा, टू क्रिएट दैट बैलेंस. Because what happens is that in race of that achieving your career goals, you somehow lose that connect. It has happened with me also, because I was so mad about film industry that somehow I lost that connect with my hometown, my parents. Aur wo hota hai ki aap roz baat jo karte the wo nahi kar pate ho. So I always tell whosoever comes to me that it is really important to strike that balance. Aap family ko bhi time dijiye, aap career ko bhi time dijiye. Aur wo bahut sabse difficult part hai obviously wo. But I think that is most important. Secondly, what I feel is that it is really important to be consistent. Like I said before, doing that same thing again and again is what will make you perfect, and not giving up. is another, because if you do it for 10 years, even gods will shower rain at you. It's not happening before 10 years. So yeah, that's the answer.
And now it's time for a rapid fire quiz. Let's see if you answer these questions correctly. Abhilash is the DM of which city?
Rampur.
Sandeep Bhaiya passes which exam at the end of the series?
PCS.
Who says plan bhi hona chahiye bhai, Abhilash bahut zaruri hai?
SK.
Where does Abhilash meet Dhairya for the first time?
Where does Abhilash meets?
Dhairya for the first time.
Accountant's room.
Which place in the series is considered a hub for UPSC coaching?
Rajinder Nagar, Mukherjee Nagar.
Who gets married in the series?
Guri.
What is the full name of SK?
Shwet Ketu Jha.
Perfect, sir. Your journey was so inspiring, sir, and I hope it serves as a great example to the youth out there. Thank you so much
for
giving your value.
Thank you for calling me.
Thanks.
Thank you.